Found their voice, this split for sure. You can see the cheers fulls there. Hoping for a glad plane to be flying into the station. That's a great drawing of the cast. The green casters. Yeah, actually, you know what? There's
you know, you might have on. Time here, Achilles. Or maybe not.
Well, a package is coming through. Sawn's pretty tanky, but he does lose out on the Meganar. Is kiting back, he's low. But he's going low. Can they get it? But the shield from Kuzan might just say no. But Kuro, he goes down. First blood over to Jhin Air. And my god, we were just 40 seconds shy.
And poking his head around bot side, pops the ultimate.
How's that pop? The shield's coming down here from Kuzan. Big grand entrance, popping up multiple members as Kuzan tries to get out, right. But he cannot do it. The Rend from Kramer will take him down, and Snowflower, he's just going to get speared in the face. He will fall. Double kill over to Kramer.
Skin this, and they have no vision behind. The blasting plant undid them last time, Achilles.
What happens here again? MT getting ready to take a ride, but Tuzan has the pop up. The Rend will come through with a smite.
By a Freaker with no ability to ward behind, they jump over. Watch for the equalizer here, because the pinch here is good, like you say. Big engage, but the equalizer is perfect. About as good as you could ask for. Meant there was no way for a Freaker to be aggressed on. Jhin Air had to go backwards because they had no path to walk forwards. That meant two kills.
Getting through those Baron empowered minions is going to prove difficult because of that Infinity Edge. Big damage onto the turret, but Blade Caller comes through and he just rips right through Tucson, overstepping his bounds.
The game was 35 minutes of flatline, let's be real.
Oh, jeez. Well, Snowflower just takes all of the damage, but now they're going to try to turn this one around in onto Kuro. He's got the flash available, Tether not going to connect. Wards, but in the meantime, the Elder Dragon is going down and the Rend is going to be there. So now, double buff going over to the side of Afrika. TP used by Sawn as well. Had the rage bar built up, was looking for the fight, but now Marin sees the opening, dashes in, looking for Teddy. The Black Shield will deny the stun. In the meantime, he's in the back line, knocks up two as he dashes away to keep himself alive as Marin chases in, looking for Umpti, taking the Gragas rather low, but the shields are there from Kuzan. They're trying to keep him alive. Massive Gnarl, but pushing them back up the lane. Teddy is going to find the first kill as he gets rid of Kramer, as he gets rid of Tucson, looking for a little bit more, and all of a sudden, Jhin Air are right smack back into the middle of this game. Quite a bit of damage and wave clear. He has the double buffs. Will be doing true damage. I mean, just look at the hits in onto Kuzan. Jhin Air have the run for the health, but Kuro, he's going to go for it. Sawn trying to leap in for him. Doesn't have the stun. We'll have the wallop. Throws down the barrel to try to, the fist to try to slow him up there. And Kuro will die. So big overstep by him. You can see he's got a grin on his face. It's already fallen down below half. And Kramer hasn't been able to get any red stacks in. So it seems like this is just going to be Baron going over to Jhin Air, who now has a second lease on life. Boulder comes through. Double so with these shields that come out.
Never had to get to this point, but Afrika lengthened the game.
That's like two autos there. They're going to look for the engage. Pop up does come through as Kuzan takes a hell of a lot of damage, gets the redemption to keep him topped off and has the shield.
There's only a single target CC. Jhin Air's going to take a third inhibitor right now.
Be one hell of a turnaround if Afrika can somehow pull it off. Dark Binding connecting in onto Marin. It's going to get whittled away at by Teddy, but can't quite find the damage to pop that GA. They were knocked to the side, and Umpti very overextended. Still has the flash, but he's holding on to it. Red Sax will come through, flashes at the last second, and barely stays alive. Teddy with the Featherstorm, not really going to line him up with the Blade Caller. Finds the root, though, from the Dark Binding, in onto the Rumble. He goes into the Zonius, but it's going to be a turnaround. Teddy has fallen, Umpti going down shortly thereafter, as Kuro finds the kill and so on. He's just going to try to retreat, flashes away, but it seems like he's dead to rights, because there's so many members that can chase it onto him. He will fall, but in the meantime,
really difficult. Actually taking down this inhibitor is a big boon to them, but if they play a long game, they probably lose, so it's time to go Rambo if you ask the Afrika Freaks.
Marin is tanking up, and Kuro can shred this first one. Tucson goes in, gets the pop up, and that's going to be Kuzan going down immediately. Snowflower with the Soul Shackles will get the roots coming through redemption. Maybe able to keep him alive for the moment, but now the Nexus is exposed. They have the damage, and they will take it out. A slobber knocker of a game, 49 and a half minutes. Afrika Freaks, early lead, thrown away into the hands of Jhin Air, but they hand it right back over to them all in a moment.
And the throw analogy is so on point with this game. Nothing happened for 32 minutes, and then everything happened in the back end of the game. Jhin Air had everything ready for them. They literally had the ability to knock down all the pins, but then they made a mistake around the bot side, and it felt like they'd be fine because they already had three inhibitors down. But at this point in the game with double AD carry, Afrigo just forced through the inhibitor they prepared earlier and actually end the game against all normal logic.
Well, Jhenair will not be able to secure that fifth place spot here today, but they can still force a tiebreaker by winning the next two games. Afrika, they're at the edge. They're at the cusp of locking themselves into that wild card match against SK Telecom, who they have a winning record versus.
Afrika is playing best of ones from now on.